According to Greek literature, when the land was divided by the gods and distributed among them, Atlantis was given to Poseidon, god of the sea. Eventually, a great war broke out between the Atlanteans and the Athenians. The Atlanteans were defeated, and their control over the areas of Europe was broken. However, before the war could continue, the entire landmass of Atlantis sank to the bottom of the sea. The island of Atlantis, its people, and even its memory were swallowed by the depths. There is a vivid description of this city written by Plato, in which Atlantis was described as an island consisting mostly of mountains in the north. A great plain, in an oblong shape in the south, spread 555 kilometers long and 370 kilometers wide. The city of Atlantis sat just outside the outer ring of water and spread across the plain, covering a circle of 17 kilometers. This was a densely populated area where the majority of the population lived. Now, here's the twist. There is no written record of the existence of Atlantis, except for its mention in the works of that great philosopher. Even the location of this utopia remains a mystery. People have worked through various hypotheses, giving the location they believe it should be. Surprisingly, many of these proposed sites were not in the Atlantic Ocean at all. The Azores. Plato quoted Egyptian priests who believed that Atlantis fought a war with the ancient Mediterraneans and then sank in 9400 BC. Because Atlantis was said to be a large island in the Atlantic Ocean, surrounded by continents, it was thought to be in the mid-Atlantic. The sinking of Atlantis left only a few scattered islands, islands such as the Azores, perhaps. The Sahara. The Sahara Desert, and more specifically, the Tassili and Ahaggar Mountains in southern Algeria, Tunisia, or both, has been proposed as the actual site of Atlantis. When the French colonized North Africa, they soon discovered that a lost world existed in southern Algeria, and that the ancient harbor of Carthage was an exact miniature of the capital of Atlantis described by the Egyptian priests. Malta. Malta has huge ancient structures dated at 9,000 years or older, and are said by some to be the oldest stone ruins in the world. Malta is a small, rocky island, but it once had elephants and shows evidence of having been destroyed in a cataclysmic wave. The island is far too small to have been Atlantis, but it shows that the Mediterranean has a very different place 12,000 years ago. South America. Due to the gigantic ruins in Peru and Bolivia, and the evidence that Tiahuanaco was destroyed in a cataclysm, South America has been proposed as the site of Atlantis by a number of early writers. The location of Atlantis has remained a tantalizing mystery for thousands of years, but very recently, a US-led research team has claimed to have found the legendary lost city of Atlantis. Scientists claim to have pinpointed the exact location of the tsunami-doomed metropolis under the mudflats in southern Spain. In conclusion, we're not sure if this utopia ever existed or if it was just the dream of an old philosopher. However, if it did exist, it sounds like a truly incredible place to live.